In this section, we're going to build our overview screen of our paint color process. We're going to use the Siemens HMI symbol library, as well as WinCC standard objects and smart objects to create the user interface. So let's get started. We're going to start by opening the overview screen that we created in the last session. And if you remember, we just had a placeholder text there. So I'm going to get rid of that and just set my zoom. So first, let's just pull out our major objects so that we can place them. I'm going to go to my controls palette and choose the Siemens HMI symbol library object and pull it out. Now, by default, it comes out as a pump, so we need a couple of pumps. I want to be able to change the color, so I'm going to access the properties by double-clicking. I'll go to style. I'm going to change symbol appearance to shaded, which will allow me to control the color, and also the adjust to allow me to size and shape the pump the way that I want. I'll just click OK. And then I can just duplicate this. And then I can duplicate it again, maybe make it a little larger, and then we'll double-click and configure this one as a tank. I'll go down to tanks and pick tank 3. Now for this particular tank, we're not going to change the color. And I kind of like the way that it looks original, so I'll do original. So we also had a 55-gallon tank here that the outflow was going to. So I'll duplicate this. Do my tank. And then just kind of make it a lot smaller. So we'll probably be tweaking the size on these controls for a little while until we get it looking the way that we want. We had a valve coming out, so I will duplicate another object, double click, and find a valve. This one looks good. And we'll just kind of space it. And then for my outflow, I'm just going to use a tube object. There's a little bend object here. I'll pull it out, and then I can use my rotate and flip to make this the way that I want, and I can increase, decrease the angle. There we go. And then finally, we had a little drip coming out, and that is also one of these objects, so I'm going to right-click duplicate, type in N for nature. There's my drop. I'll click OK. So we have a lot of our major objects there on the screen. So we need a fill level for this tank so we can visually tell what level it is. So I'm going to use a filled polygon. I'll click the polygon, and each time I click, it's just kind of dropping a vertice. Cool thing about it is I can just kind of shape it the way that I want. And I want to make this look like it's kind of a transparent hole in the tank that you can look in and see the liquid. First, I need to turn off the global color scheme. And for this to kind of look rounded, I would go to my styles, go to fill pattern, and choose kind of this rounded gradient background. It's going to look kind of weird. I have this bright green color in the middle, and where that color comes from is what we call the fill pattern color. So those two properties work together. For this to look rounded, I'm going to choose kind of a lighter color for the middle, and then on the background color, I'm going to use darker. And so it kind of looks like I'm looking inside of a tank here. Then I'm going to duplicate this, and this will be the layer that actually shows the fill level. So I'm going to use kind of the same colors, but let's go with, say, a white. So my background color would be kind of darker. Fill pattern color in the middle is going to be white. And then I am going to go to my filling, and I'll turn on dynamic filling, and then I'll put my fill level somewhere in the middle. And then when I align these, then I've kind of got this nice little object that looks like there's a background, and I can use the fill level property to change the fill level, say with a tag or something. And that's the way we'll do it. And of course, since we're doing a color process, the settings for red, green, and blue will define the color of this, so it'll look kind of cool. Next, let's put our labels around the pump. So I'll use a static text. We had one up here that said paint color process overview. I will put that, and I just hold my shift key down to hit enter to go to the next line. Make that a lowercase o, just hit enter, and then just kind of size this. And we want our background to be transparent. I can go to styles, get rid of my weight, and use my fill pattern to make the background transparent. And then I think I used blue font on that, and I can use my menu bar to just quickly change that if I want. We had some similarly formatted labels on the pump, so I'll just duplicate this. We were just using red, green, and blue supply on these. And then the font color on that is going to match the color. So there's my red supply. So I'll start kind of moving these around. I want to make the font a little smaller on those because we're going to need some room here. I think I had the pump right up under that. Move these guys out of the way. And then we had a label. So I'll just take a static text. And this was pump one. And another way to get my formatting right, I can just highlight the label that I like and use the eyedroppers, suck the properties out of it, highlight where I want them to go, and use the paste properties. And then we can just place our pumps here using our eyeballs. I'm going to hold my shift key down, select all the pumps, use my alignment tools, so I'll align them left, and then I will evenly space. And then I'll use my shift key to highlight my labels. I can duplicate these, and I can use my cursor keys. Just using the cursor keys to move them by 1 pixel, but if I hold my shift key down, it'll move them by 10 pixels. So I like to do this, and that will be my green supply. So we'll go ahead and just do that. And then for my four color, I can choose green out of here, kind of a darker green. This will be pump two. And it will also be that same color green. And then finally, I'll use Control C, Control V to duplicate those. So it looks like I'm going to have to do a little bit of moving around here just to kind of get everything to line up. But this is kind of normal to kind of get these where I need them to be. And then this will be my blue supply. Set the font color, set the pump, give myself a little bit more room. And there's my pump three, and I'll set my font color there. So that gives us our pumps. Next, we want to do the hoppers on top of the tank. So we're going to use another Siemens HMI symbol library. I'll just grab one of these pumps, duplicate it, double click, and the objects that I used were actually also tanks. They were hoppers. And I believe we used these. So I'll just click OK. We had red, green, and blue. So I can change the color by going to the control properties. And on these objects, it's the four color that makes the color, not background. This would be blue. I'll choose a dark blue. And just kind of move it down. And then I'll duplicate that. Move it over. And then duplicate that one. Move it where I want. The middle one is going to be green. So we'll choose green for that one. We'll choose red for this one. We had labels on top of the hoppers that said R, G, and B. So we'll just use a static text for that. There's my R. And I'll just kind of get them all down there. And then I can manipulate the properties the way that I want. Duplicate. Duplicate. And then I can use my lasso to just take those objects, use my alignment tools. This would be G, this would be B. So we can just lasso all three of these and set the styles all at once to be rounded. And then on the red, on our fill pattern color, kind of a light red, background color, kind of make it a dark red. And then we want our font to be white. And then we'll do the same thing with green and blue. Our fill pattern color is going to be kind of a lighter green. Background color is going to be a darker green. Font's going to be white. Same thing with blue. There we go. And now we need to do our piping. And we have this great tube objects called a polygon tube, and it works just like a regular polygon. You just keep clicking as you want to drop vertices and then double click when you're done. So the first one is going to be red. So I'm just going to click here, double click there to let it go. And then I can use my arrow keys to just kind of place it. Let's do the next one. So here's the next polygon 2. We'll go up here and we'll just kind of give it a gradual turn. And then we'll drop it down here and then turn it right into the pump. And now onto the blue. And we'll bring it right in. And we'll just kind of tweak it so everything kind of matches up. So I've got all the tubes selected, and I'll go down and turn off my global color scheme as well. Finally, we had a valve on these pipes. And so I'm just going to take a pump. I'll duplicate it. I'll double click. I'll just type in V to go for valves. And I think we use this horizontal control valve. And I can just put it right on the pipe. And then I'll duplicate it. And then, of course, we had labels for the valves. So I'll duplicate this label. Put it up. Change this to valve 1. Valve 2. And valve 3. So we'll make the font colors match the color here. So that's valve 1, and then valve 2 is going to be green, and valve 3 is a blue valve. So we'll do that. Okay. So we need IO fields that will go on each of the color hoppers. And one of the cool features of WinCC 7.4 is I can just drag tags directly out and it will create an appropriate IO field for them. So if I go down to my structure instances, you'll see we have our color structures. So starting with the blue, so I can just pull that out and drop it. And I want to format this. So I go back to my properties menu, set my alignment. We'll go with a bigger size here. And we're going to make it transparent, so that's under my styles menu. I'll make it transparent and drop the border weight to 0. And of course, for all this to take effect, we have to turn off the global color scheme. And we'll make the font color white. And then I can just move this right on top of the control. Now we're going to have a hard time seeing that white, so I think we're going to have to go with black. There we go. So we can see that IO field is actually hooked up to our blue color strength. So I can just duplicate that, put it over here on green. And then of course, I'm gonna right click because this needs to be the green tag. I'll right click, do tag. Here's my green color strength. And then we'll just repeat that. There's my red color strength. Finally, we need a label for our tank. So I'll just take one of these labels, right click, duplicate, put it down here. And this is mix tank 1. And we will go with black, maybe a little bit higher font. And I think we're ready to save. So I'll just hit save.